If you enjoy the content on this channel, please like and subscribe. Painkiller is an American drama limited series made for Netflix and created by Micah, Fitzerman-Blue and Noah Harpster. The six-episode series was based on Patrick Radden's Keefe's New Yorker article, The Family That Built an Empire of Pain and Painkiller, An Empire of Deceit and the Origin of America's Opioid Epidemic by Barry Meier. The show focuses on the birth of the opioid crisis, with emphasis on Purdue Pharma, a company owned by Richard Sackler and his family that was the manufacturer of OxyContin. The Sackler family has been described as the most evil family in America and the worst drug dealers in history. Painkiller premiered on Netflix on August 10th, 2023. The cast includes Uzo Eduba as Edie Flowers. The character is a fictional composite of real investigators who looked into Purdue Pharma and OxyContin. Edie Flowers, the fictional character, opposes the real-life pharmaceutical tycoon Richard Sackler, played here by Matthew Broderick, who is involved in the development of OxyContin. Taylor Kitsch as Glenn Krieger. The character is also a composite, which was created to represent the estimated 300,000 Americans who have died over the past two decades from overdosing on prescription opioids such as OxyContin. Wes Duchovny as Shannon Schaefer. The character is also an amalgamation of many people who worked as sales representatives for Purdue Pharma. Matthew Broderick as Richard Sackler. Richard Sackler is an American billionaire businessman and physician who is the chairman and president of Purdue Pharma, a former company best known as the developer of OxyContin, whose connection to the opioid epidemic in the United States was the subject of multiple lawsuits and fines, and that filed for bankruptcy in 2019. Clark Gregg, here as Arthur Sackler. Arthur, who was born in 1913 and died in 1987, was an American psychiatrist and marketer of pharmaceuticals whose fortune originated in medical advertising and trade publications. He was also an art collector. He was one of three patriarchs of the controversial Sackler family pharmaceutical dynasty. Since his death, Sackler's reputation has been tarnished due to his company Purdue Pharma's central role in the opioid crisis. Many of the museums and galleries that Sackler donated to have distanced themselves from him and his family in the wake of the opioid crisis and the Sackler family's resulting reputational fall. On December 9, 2021, the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York City officially removed the Sackler family name from the galleries, which had been named after them. Some trivia notes. During an interview with Leila Fadel on National Public Radio's Morning Edition, producer and director Peter Berg explained that the disclaimers on each episode are read by real family members of people affected by or lost to opioid addiction. The cast contains several performers who are children of actors who were famous before them. For example, Matthew Broderick, Richard Sackler, is the son of James Broderick. Wes Duchovny, who plays Shannon Schaefer, is the daughter of Tia Leone, and David Duchovny, famous for The X-Files. And Tyler Ritter, who plays John Brownlee, the prosecutor, is the son of John Ritter, famous for Three's Company. In August of 2023, the Supreme Court of the United States temporarily blocked a nationwide $6 billion settlement with OxyContin maker Purdue Pharma and its owners, the Sackler family, that would shield the members of the family from civil lawsuits over the effects of opioids. SCOTUS has agreed to hear arguments in December of 2023. Just a quick background on the opioid epidemic. The epidemic, also referred to this opioid crisis, is the rapid increase in the overuse, misuse and abuse and overdose of deaths attributed to either in part or in the whole class of drugs called opioids since the 1990s. It includes the significant medical, social, psychological, demographic and the economic consequences of the medical, non-medical and recreational abuse of these medications. Opioids, of course, are a diverse class of moderate to strong painkillers, including oxycodone, commonly sold under the trade name OxyContin. The potency and availability of these substances, despite the potential risk of addiction and overdose, have made them popular as both medical treatments and as recreational drugs. Even though the drugs are effective at treating acute pain, there is a strong debate over whether they are effective in treating chronic or high-impact intractable pain, as the risks may outweigh the benefits, as they are highly addictive and can cause respiratory depression, which can lead to death. Purdue Pharma was an American privately held pharmaceutical company founded by John Purdue Gray. It was sold to Arthur Mortimer and Raymond Sackler in 1952 and then owned principally by the Sackler family and their descendants. Purdue then filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection on September 15, 2019 in New York City. On October 21, 2020, it was reported that Purdue had reached a settlement potentially worth $8.3 billion, admitting that it knowingly and intentionally conspired and agreed with others to aid and abet doctors in dispensing medication without legitimate medical purpose. Members of the Sackler family will additionally have to pay $225 million and the company would close. Now, of course, look, there is no getting away from the absolute awful crimes that the Sackler family committed. All in the hope, of course, of lining their own pockets with making more and more money and gaining more power and influence. The opioid crisis is an absolute tragedy. And the problem with this whole story is that People in pain trusted their doctors and relied on them to prescribe medication that would help them, that would alleviate this pain. Instead, of course, it made them addicts and eventually resulted in many of their own deaths. This story is truly one of tragedy, greed, corruption, and despair. Unfortunately, when it comes to a show like Painkiller, you're going to have to directly compare it to a show like Dopesick, a miniseries also covering the opioid crisis. That series, of course, starred Michael Keaton, Peter Skarsgård, Michael Stuhlbarg here playing Richard Sackler, and I found it a much more deeper, introspective show on this awful crisis. Albeit with its heart in the right place, Painkiller relies on the sensationalism, over-dramatization, and over-the-top spectacle of this awful crisis. Look, what it does do is honors the victims of the opioid crisis, and each episode having real people now talk about their lost loved ones really impacted me and sent the message home. Unfortunately, after that, though, the show does rely too much on dramatization, in-your-face direction and narrative, and sometimes hammy scripts and strange sequences, particularly involving the Sackler family. You can see director Peter Berg here, of course, has a deep hatred for them, as most people should, as they were evil people. But in the same breath, though, the show portrays them as idiots and doesn't want to pull any punches, and rather just over the top shows Peter Berg's absolute distaste and hatred for these people, which I don't believe is very good directing. Matthew Droderick here is completely annoying as Richard Sackler. I know he's meant to be, but in the same breath, though, he's so offbeat and irritating that you can't really involve yourself with the character. The show is tonally confusing. It's all over the place, it's in your face, and it's just far too busy. Yes, it hits the right messages in terms of telling you how awful this crisis was, and the acting, of course, is what saved it, particularly from Uza Uduba as Edie Flowers. She really is the heart and soul of the show, and basically carries the show on her back, and without her performance, I feel the series would have just fallen flat. I also didn't particularly like the idea of having Arthur Sackler, who of course is dead, now talking to Richard Sackler as a sort of ghost version of himself, and he's played irritatingly here by Clark Gregg. Taylor Kitsch is good here as Glenn Krieger, the man now addicted to OxyContin, and his story is truly tragic and really hits home hard. And Wes Duchovny tries her best as Shannon Schaefer here, the misguided and naive salesperson for Purdue Pharma. Look, the intentions of the show were good, but the show is just too over the top. I found it more irritating than moving at times. Look, it held my interest, but you have to unfortunately make the comparison to a much better well-done show in Dopesick. And frankly, if you want to watch a series about this most awful of epidemics, I would far more likely recommend a show like Dopesick, which paints a more accurate picture of the opioid crisis and the families and individuals involved. For me, Dopesick addressed the opioid epidemic with respect, and it develops all of its characters, where Painkiller wants to slap you across the face with a satirical approach, miscasting and its shallow writing. As I said before, if it wasn't for the fantastic performance here from Uzi Odobo, this series definitely would have fallen short for me. With its over-the-top, bombastic approach to a very serious real situation, albeit a show with its heart in the right place, Painkiller just misses the mark on this most serious of situations. Painkiller gets a 6 out of 10.